Here's the thing. Isn't that invincible in professional sports? We all know that. And Adam Rodgers can point that out. This way. Yeah, you know, Odell Beckham Jr. can point that out. J.J. Watt can point that out. Yes. Could be good examples for it. But watching, this is going to be interesting. When you give money to guys, you never know how that money is going to change them on the court.
No question.
Now, have I made it? Am I going to stay? You know,
what about the Yankees guys? When they start getting paid?
Well, you hope that they or four guys that the money doesn't change them and they become professionals. Right. It's something that, you know, as I'm sure these young guys have watched, these guys coming out throwing the first pitch, whether it be Andy Pettit or Paul O'Neill or any of those guys that were part of those great teams of the 90s, I think they understand that. But, you know, for me, when I think about this kind of money and I think about what's out there, the one person that I know that will be competitive will be Russell Westbrook. Oh, yeah. It'll be LeBron James.
So
those two guys every night sit there motivated.
Right. You got it. I mean, you're putting the faith in the guys to be self-motivated. And listen, it's a little bit of a leap of faith. You know, we've seen it where some athletes don't pan out once they get paid. They just turn it off. You know, I was never that way. A lot of guys are not that way. That's what makes a true professional. But it's tough, you know, for general managers and owners to, you know, figure out who they're going to take the gamble on and who's going to work out.
I think Jerry said this about James Harden. Basically, it was missing in a game last year.
Yes. Yeah, Game 7.
Game 7.
Spurs.
I don't know what happened to him. Yeah. I don't know where he went. I don't know what was going on. But then the Houston Rockets suddenly gave him a big contract.
Mm-hmm.
And then Leslie Alexander sells the team for $2.1 billion. I mean, you talk about selling at the
right
cash.
That's exactly right. Yeah.
But that's one of those situations where, okay, here's a guy we're going to give money to. Now, are we going to make sure that he's going to be there for every Game 7, or is he just going to check out when he wants to check out?
Yeah, you know how it is. There's some days where you're just off. You don't have it. You know, it happens. It happens in sports. I mean, I can't explain why there were nights I went 2-for-14. You know, that's what we love about sports as fans, as athletes. There's no guarantees, and that's why we all love following it. We all love watching it, but Game 7 for Harden, that's one he's going to have to forget. He helped them get to that position. Let's not forget that.
MVP
again. Yeah, exactly. So they wouldn't have been there without him, but he just had one of those days that you can't explain.
Is the LeBron stuff WWF type, what you guys are talking about, the whole LA thing? Like, why are we doing that now, a year before? And it's everywhere. I mean, people are talking about where he's going next. Why do we do that?
Well, that's
truth to it.
Listen, the NBA has it figured out. They have headlines in the summers when free agency
right.
comes up. I mean, it never goes away. They're geniuses, brilliant marketing. Look at the way the game is globally. It's phenomenal what they've been able to do around the world. This game is completely global. And LeBron, he knows how important he is. And he's like, you know, Tiger Woods was to golf, you know. And every player in golf, I know, has respect for what Tiger Woods did because they're cashing the checks now.
Right, exactly.
And it's the same with LeBron. I mean, LeBron, everyone in the NBA should look at LeBron like, thank you. You know, because of what you've done for this league, you've elevated it to this mega level. Everyone's cashing in for it. But LeBron, I caution, you know, LeBron takes some risk. He doesn't sign that long-term deal. He doesn't sign that extension. He likes to have that flexibility. It's kind of shake him up a little bit what he saw with Gordon Hayward the other night. Because he's one misstep away, and you never hope anything's going to happen like that to anyone, especially a guy like LeBron. He's been invincible.
But in fairness, he's made $1 billion already.
Yeah,
that's no question.
Forget the basketball. It's what he does.
He's probably going to sign a $300 million contract. Yeah, we're always over back a couple more minutes. What really can we expect from the Knicks? In all honesty, I know you have no idea. I have no idea what Jeff Hornacek's going to get from these guys. I'm assuming it's going to be an up-and-down attack, offensive attack, right? It's going to be like, let's go. We're going to run the ball. There's no more triangle nonsense. I mean, they'll have half-court sets when they have to have half-court sets. But this is going to be more of a running-gun team, and what about defense?
Let's be honest. This preseason, the coaching staff, they have all these new pieces. They're trying to figure it out. It's only a 3-week preseason in training camp. It was a rough preseason. They went 0-5. I mean, who can you count on? I know I can count on Tim Hardaway Jr. I hope KP is going to be healthy, because if he's healthy, I can count on him. And then you got a lot of moving parts and a lot of moving pieces. I like what they're doing. I think they brought in NBA talent, young NBA talent, and young NBA assets. Now it's time to turn the
switch. And I was a guy who, preseason, whatever, just, when are we playing the first regular season game? That's all I cared about. But these are guys that needed to be playing in the preseason because they haven't shown that much in the regular season. I'm excited for tonight. I think Jeff Hornacek, I still believe in him as a coach. I believe in the staff. Jerry Seasting's on the staff. He coached me in Minnesota with the Timberwolves, with Flip Saunders. I think he's a phenomenal coach. He's on staff. You know, they got Kurt Rambis on staff who knows how to win basketball games. He's won championships. I just have to put faith in this coaching staff to figure it out, that just believe in the process that Scott Perry and Steve Mills are doing, and this team is going to be fun to watch. I'm hoping over 30 wins. You know, I think that's a realistic, hope. You know, last year I was bullish on the over, 39 wins. I thought they were going to make the playoffs. I thought they were going to win 45, 50 games. Be maybe a home court seed. The season completely blew up. This season, I'm hoping that it's going to go in the opposite direction and this team's going to win.
Well, maybe they'll be driven and they won't have any,
thing is point guard. Like,
well, the only thing?
There's a lot of pieces, but you need a point guard in this league.
Well, I'm saying that, my hope is in 20, 30 games, Frank Ntilikina can take the reins and we can have a point guard of the future. That's my hope.
Lonzo Ball is going to be NBA Rookie of the Year.
That's what I said.
I like that.
Yeah, he was great this summer. I never watched something
like
basketball.
I like Josh Jackson. Jackson with Phoenix, to me, he should have been the number one pick. I think he's the best player in AU's the best player in college basketball coming in. Watch out for him.
Right. He'll be my pick.
All right, good luck tonight.
Thanks, Wally.
Thank you. Alan
said hi, and keep the mics on, okay?
You got it.
CBS Sports Minute brought to you by your Tri-State Ford dealers. Here's Bomer.